Hi, welcome to Moomoomath. Today we're going to look at the properties of squares. And squares are kind of the perfect quadrilateral, so there are lots of properties. Okay, the first property that is that all four sides are congruent, kind of by definition that makes a square. So all four sides are marked congruent. So if this side is 5, this side would also be 5 and 5 and 5. Then a second property is that all four angles are congruent. And we know that in a quadrilateral, there are 360 degrees. So if we divide those into four equal parts, each angle is 90 degrees. So we're going to mark those as right angles. So each angle is 90 degrees. Also, the diagonals. There are a couple properties of diagonals. The first one is the property, the diagonals bisect each other. So if we draw in W to Y and X to Z, we know that these segments are all congruent to each other. These are bisected and these are bisected, and because it is also a rectangle and a rhombus, all four half diagonals are congruent to each other too, which actually makes four isosceles triangles. If you look carefully, you have two sides congruent, and then this side is the hypotenuse of a right triangle. And we have actually right angles at the center because that's the property of a rhombus. It's also a property of a square. So we have a right isosceles triangle in here. We have the diagonals of bisect, and then the full diagonals are also congruent to each other. So we can actually calculate the length of the diagonals using the side of 5. If this side is 5 and this side is 5, we have a right triangle right here where these two angles are 45 and 45 because the angles are also bisected. So we're taking our right angle and bisecting it into 45s, and we can calculate this diagonal by just multiplying it by the square root of 2, because that's the shortcut of a 45-45-90 triangle. So that diagonal is 5 square root 2, and this diagonal would also be 5 square root 2. So we actually have four congruent triangles inside of a square. They're all 45-45-90 right triangles, and they're all congruent to each other. So those are some properties of a square, and a square is the perfect quadrilateral.